Thanks for watching Aquarium Tech today. Today, I just got something new in, and hey there. I got something new in. I'll go ahead and do an unboxing. This is an unboxing. Remember that, an unboxing, not a review. On this thing, I've noticed these have been pretty popular lately. At least according to what I've seen on YouTube. There's a lot of advertisement and stuff for these on there. Now, this is the AA UV sterilizer. I think they call it like the grain killing machine or something like that. It comes in two sizes, 9 watt and 24 watt, to my knowledge. I think it's actually an English company, because I know when I went onto their website, they had some stuff on there, but it wasn't available for United States. I think you could order it, but, you know, it doesn't use the same power. You know, it doesn't have the right hook and stuff, so... Anyways, this is so far what I know they have, and I haven't opened this one yet. I actually just got it today. I actually got it because I meant to do a video on this a while ago. I built like a little freshwater sump to kind of mix up my water for all my tanks, because obviously I think I've been telling you guys about this since I started AquariumTech. You know, with all the tanks I have, if I freaking use buckets, I mean. So I'm not even going to get started. But anyways, it's Florida summer's kicking in, and for some reason it doesn't seem like my other UV sterilizer is quite getting the job done. So I'm picking up another one, and the only reason I got this is because it's cheap, okay? Now, one of the first things I'm going to say about it, now remember, I have not used this yet. I have not used it. One of the first things I will say is it looks like a piece of crap. Okay, I'm not gonna lie, it looks like a piece of crap, but I knew that from when I bought it, okay, because I got this for like $30, it's brand new, like I got it for like $30, I think it was like $40 shipped, okay, so I couldn't go wrong with that, I mean, I saw sites online selling these 24 watt ones for 90 bucks, and this is the 24 watt one, but what's nice is it does have a power head on it. And 24 watts is pretty powerful for a UV sterilizer. I mean, I think the Core Life Turbo Twist times 12 is only like that much. So, or something like that. So that's pretty powerful, but I'm sure it's not as efficient as like, the Core Life Turbo Twist. So, but anyways, let's go ahead and do the unboxing here. As you can see, it comes in a pretty big box. Kind of nice box. First off, we have our little, it's like a little in quick start manual or instruction manual. Oh, and another reason I looked at these is because I was looking at bulb prices, and the bulbs for these things are super cheap. So. For those of you that have UV sterilizers, you know how expensive bulbs get. So, anyways, comes in like this little egg carton kind of thing. Let's open the plastic here. Man, this is tough plastic. And I'm sure there's been a lot of questions about this. I'm sure there's been some of you at least wondering about it or searching elsewhere on YouTube. Because like I said, I've been seeing a lot of people interested in these. I'm guessing because of the price. Let's see what we got. Looks like we got a little elbow. This is probably for the power head. And I'm sure this is the power head that powers it. And let's see. It looks like it's got a separate ballast in here too. Which is something new to me, because I've had the JBJ Submariners, and those things have the ballast, I guess, built into them. Man, if they would have used this plastic on the UV sterilizer, or spent as much money on the wrapping, they'd probably freaking be able to make a way better UV sterilizer. But I shouldn't say that, I haven't used it yet. That's probably not a good thing for me to say. So. Anyways. Looks like what we've got here is the main housing for the light bulb. You get a little sponge that goes on here. I guess this is probably just to keep you know, big debris out of it. Now, I usually don't like to have you know, sponges and stuff before it goes into the UV sterilizer because the bad stuff that gets sucked in can easily just grow in the sponge, so it won't actually get sucked in. So, but this is, I mean, this seems all right, kind of like the JBJ one. You know, it's really thin, coarse foam, so it probably is only going to catch big debris, but I've always just liked using power head strainers. It's always worked just fine, but it is good because when debris gets in there, it obviously blocks some of the water from getting sterilized, and plus it's probably not so good for your power head or your UV sterilizer. So, alright. And let's see if this thing opens. Because if you guys watched any of my other UV sterilizer videos, you'll know one of the things that makes a quality UV sterilizer is a quartz sleeve, okay? So, this thing obviously advertises the fact that the water directly touches the UVC lamp. Now, I don't know if that's a good idea. I mean, that thing better be in there, you know, watertight. You know, all it sounds like it's only going to take one little thing for, you know, something to go wrong. Let's see. It looks like you got a few extra sponges. It's like you've got a bracket. Kind of ghetto bracket there. Just like a big rubber band with a suction cup on it. Looks like probably a bracket for the actual power head. Looks like another elbow probably for the power head. Let's see if I can't get this out. Man, this plastic is tough. I mean, who the hell makes plastic this tough? And I'm guessing this is probably the ballast right here. This is a big boy. I'm going to be using that outside. I'm probably going to have to wrap that up in something. Or I'm sorry, that's probably the power supply. And this is the ballast. Rather, this is the ballast, okay. Oops. Alright, so I'll kind of sort it out here. You've got your power supply. You've got your ballast. You've got your power head. You've got the actual lamp and flow path and the actual UV sterilizer here, elbows, and the brackets here. So let's see if I can't put this thing together real quick. I'm guessing this goes like this. See, I'm going to have to cheat here and look at the instructions, or the box. Because this is a little odd. I've never quite seen one like this. And like I said, I think it's by some English company that makes it, or some European company. So it's a little odd for here. Alright. This one goes like this. Alright, so this is what it looks like fully assembled. As you can tell, it's pretty long. It's got a pretty big bulb. Of course, that doesn't surprise me, but from the way it's designed, it looks like that's probably a good thing. So that means the water has to travel around it more. Alright, I wanted to read the instructions real quick, guys, because I was a little confused here on the fixture, because it looks like you can't actually take the top off apart to get to the bulb. It looks like, I think what happens is when you need a new bulb, you actually replace this whole piece, I think. I looked in the directions. I mean, it doesn't say anything about opening this up. So that'd be kind of weird to have to replace this whole thing. But, I mean, this thing is kind of made out of cheapy plastic. I mean, you can feel it and you hold it in your hands. It's just cheapy plastic. So I'm guessing that's what you're supposed to do, because I certainly can't get this apart. I'm afraid I'm going to break it. So, this top part here, because I was going to show you guys the bulb and their supposed water path that's supposed to work. But basically how it's supposed to work is you might be able to see it. And I'm talking about the flow path, like how it's supposed to kind of help entrap the water for a little bit longer is. There's little lines. It almost looks like a Christmas tree kind of thing. There's like lines in the plastic going down like this on each side. And what it's supposed to do is it's supposed to make the water curve around it and zigzag in there before it comes out. Oops, wrong way. So, I mean, that's a little weird that they would do that, but I'm guessing that's the way it is. I mean, if I figure it out eventually, you know, I'll probably put out another update and just do a whole review on it. But of course, that won't be for a while. But anyways, I'll also show you guys how to take apart this power head real quick while I'm at it, since it's probably going to be a while till I do a review on this. Basically, as you can see here, I'm just taking off all the elbows and the pieces to hold the bracket, basically. And let's see, where's my screwdriver? And you basically just take this bottom part and you should just push it up. I'm trying to think of which power head this is exactly like. I can't think of what this is. Oh, you know what this is exactly like? The power head on here, the pump, is exactly like the one that goes on the Aquarium filters. You know how the Aquarium filters, the actual pump isn't on the filter, it's on the suction tube. So, but anyways, you just pop this top off. You got your impeller, and that's pretty much it. So, and that's really all you have to worry about. It's a very simple thing, very cheap, very simple. So, and as you can see, that's pretty much what it comes with. And one thing about the manual, it's not a color manual or anything, and it's not very descriptive either. I kind of have to jock them on the manual again, too. It doesn't... So, that's all I can really say about it. So, if you're looking for a cheap power head, a cheap UV sterilizer that can just plop right in your tank or your sump, you know, this might not be a bad idea, but... From what I see here, it's probably not going to be the best thing I've ever used. But, you know, I shouldn't say that because I don't know. I haven't used it. All right. So if you guys have any questions, just let me know. Thanks for tuning in.